I would go out and buy a starter book. A starter book is like a teach yourself, Asimil, colloquial, any of those. It almost doesn't matter. I just find it's comfortable to have a book, a little book that gives you a bit of an overview of the language. There's typically, 20 or 12 chapters that introduce some aspects of the language in each chapter. They have a dialogue, some audio, some explanations, and I kind of go through them predominantly to get a sense of the language, to read some, to get an overview of the grammar, not expecting to remember much. It's just kind of an introduction, get my feet wet, so to speak. Then, as soon as I could, I would get into interesting content. How soon I can get into interesting content will depend on the language. But I would start trying, and I would do it at Link, obviously, because there I can look up every word, I can save words. I'm used to that. That's my favorite sort of learning environment. But my sort of modus operandi is to get into a situation where I can listen and read, because listening in combination with reading is so powerful. And so for an initial 6 months or so, I would only, and so then people say, well, how can you listen to things you don't understand? I get that all the time. How can you listen if you don't know the words? Obviously, when you start out, you have to listen to short bits of content because you don't understand. And you have to listen to content where you have the transcript. And again, it should be 30 seconds long because you're going to be looking up words, you're going to be struggling, you don't understand. You're in that early process of discovering the language. But to listen to something, you have to have the transcript so that you can look up the words. All right? Also, listening and reading go together. Why? Because we listen to something that has been recorded. All right? That's a record. It's an audio record of something that someone said. But writing is a written record. Before they had, tape recorders or MP3 files, all they had was writing. That was the only way to record what was said. And the writing is a visual representation of the words. I find that I need both. If I just hear it, I won't remember it. Not a chance. If I'm talking to my tutor and she gives me a new word in Ukrainian, if I don't see it written down, I haven't got a chance of remembering that word. But if I hear it often enough and see it often enough, that's the visual representation. If I combine the two, I have a chance of accumulating those words. So, in order for that to work in the initial period, which might be 1, 2, 3 months, you've got to listen more than once to the same content. And so that's what I would do. Therefore, it has to be short. And you have to, even though the content is boring, it's the challenge of trying to make sense out of this new language that makes it interesting enough, stimulating, challenging enough that I can actually listen over and over because I'm still not getting certain parts of it, even though I've read it and I've looked up the words and I've kind of pieced together what it means. When I listen to it, it's still a blur. So therefore, there's that challenge that keeps you focused. You're going to listen to it again, read it again. And also in the beginning, I'm more likely to review words and phrases using my flashcards or other of the activities that we have at Link, closed tests or multiple choice or whatever, to try to somehow, because I have to very sort of intensively work this stuff because it's so new to me. Now, gradually, as I progress, and remember again, I'm listening to content that's short, for which I have the transcript. And hopefully, it's relatively easy because it's designed for beginners. And you can get that out of your beginner book. You can find lots of such content at Link for different languages. Some languages have more than others. And then, but as early as possible, I want to get to interesting content because after a while, it becomes boring to listen to stuff that's essentially boring. So I have to move to a stage where I'm now motivated by my interest in the content. And for me, very often that means books related to the history of the country where the language is spoken. And then it continues. It's that combination of the sound and the visual representation of the words, repeated, repeated, repeated.